But to really understand pollination, we need to take a look inside a flower, and this California poppy will do just the trick. You and I are going to do a flower dissection. All right, I've also set up my phone camera so we can zoom in and get a closer look at the different parts of the flower. But the first thing we're going to do is remove the flower from the stem and take a closer look at all of the petals. It is worth saying, I'm using a sharp knife, so please do be careful. Like lots of flowers that want to attract pollinators, they are bright in colour, and this helps to get the animals' attention, a bit like a sign saying, hey, come and drop by. But it is worth saying that some pollinators, like honeybees, don't see exactly like we do. Bees see blue colours best, so when you see a blue or a purple flower, you can be pretty sure that the plant makes that flower especially to attract bee pollinators. Notice the shape. Can you see how the petals are actually helping to guide the pollinator into the flower? It's a little bit like a tunnel, but to look at the inside like a bee would, we should carefully peel back these petals to get a closer look inside. All right, okay, there we go. Can you see that? Okay, now we're getting to the exciting part. I'm actually going to remove these, as after all, this is a dissection. Here we go. Very careful. And the last one. Oh, look at that. Can you see those dangly bits? Well, all of those are known as stamen, and they're typically made up of two parts. You have sort of the long dangly bit, which is the filament, and then on the end, you have these fluffy pads called anthers, and those are usually covered in tiny grains of pollen. When a honeybee visits a flower, it's looking for two things. The first one is nectar, which is a sugary liquid normally stored right down in the base of the flower. They slurp this up, take it back to the hive, and turn it into honey. The other thing they're looking for is pollen. Now, pollen can be mixed with honey to create a special type of bee food that they feed to the growing bees, the larvae. And sometimes pollen is mixed with tree sap to make a really sticky glue that they can use to seal up the hive so it doesn't have any cracks. But regardless of whether a bee is visiting a flower to collect pollen or nectar, when they fly into those petals, they can't help but buzz around all of those stamen and get covered in the pollen. And some of that pollen gets stuck to their fuzzy, hairy bodies, which means when they fly to the next flower, the pollen will travel with them. In fact, I can show you this. The bees returning to the hive are bringing back nectar and pollen, and you can see their little legs are absolutely covered in it. A honeybee's entire body is actually covered in hair, even their eyeballs are hairy. But they do have a special collection of hairs on their back legs called pollen baskets. And this is where a honeybee can mix pollen with saliva and really pack it in. And you can see the bright yellow baskets. That's where they've really loaded the pollen up. But not all of the pollen that sticks to their fuzzy bodies will make it back to the hive. When the bee arrives at her next flower, some of those pollen grains will fall off her fuzz and land on this part of the flower. It's called the stigma. Those pollen grains will then travel down this tube, called the style, all the way to the bulge at the bottom that we call the ovary. Now the ovary, the style, and the stigma together are called the pistil. Now we get to the really exciting part, but to see it, I'm actually going to cut open the pistil. And make sure when you're dissecting your flower to be super careful. So let's just slice that in half. Yeah! Awesome, this is the good bit. Inside the ovary are lots and lots of tiny little eggs. When some pollen from another flower makes its way to the ovary and joins with one of these eggs, something called fertilisation happens, and the end result is a seed. So when the rest of the flower dies off, this part of the plant will swell up and fall to the ground, releasing those seeds till they grow up to become a new plant. So, thanks to pollinators like honeybees searching for food, the plants that provide that food are able to reproduce and keep on living. How cool is that? But of course, it's not just bees that transport pollen and pollinate plants. Other animals can be pollinators too. Flies, butterflies, and even bats can accidentally carry pollen between flowers to allow fertilisation to take place. pollination might be something that pollinators do accidentally, but it is an incredibly important process for plants all over the world. It's important for us as humans too, because we rely on plants that are fertilised by insects for food. All of these fruits and vegetables, from apples to watermelons, are pollinated by bees. In fact, 84% of the crops in Europe are pollinated by insects. Even the beef for your roast dinners or the milk you put in your cereal depend on bees, because they pollinate the alfalfa plants that cows eat. However, there is a bit of a problem, because in recent years, the number of honeybees and native bees has been going down. It might be because of the chemicals some farmers put onto their crops to keep pests away, the lack of wildflower meadows, or it could be because of disease. But without the bees to do the pollinating, we might not be able to get all of our favourite foods. A world without bees is a world without strawberries. In the meantime, there's lots you can do to encourage local pollinators into your garden or green spaces. You could start by just leaving a really messy area where lots of wildflowers could grow, or you could plant them a bee cafe. Just take a look at one of my other YouTube videos on how you can do it. Now, subscribe. Hi, bee. Subscribe for more beekeeping videos. As always, stay curious, and I'll see you soon. Bye. Yada, 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 yada. Pollinating all the plants. Excuse me, dog. Pollinating all of the plants. But what actually, no, moo. Focus, focus. Of course. Ooh, that's not good. Focus. All right, okay. So, crumbs. Go on. Hey, there we go. It's also, oof. It's, oof. Because they pollinate the alfalfa plant. Learned. All of these fruits and vegetables. You coming over to say hi, Bumblebee? Come on in. Can you hear that? We're blessed.